or make you laugh, make you cry, like ain't life funny? Ugh.
I'm gonna skip Bayless at this point, Matt. I don't know, bro.
You're done,
like,
huh?
It's Requiem for a Cowboy, man. I'm telling you, bro. Like, it's straight up, like, play the little fucking sad music in the back with, like, what is it? The Two Real World on Dave Chappelle. Ooh. And it's just me just.
Give your speech right now to Cowboy.
Just turning the, I'm just turning the lights off. I'm just turning the lights off in the stadium. Hey, everybody, I just want to let y'all know it's been an awesome 20-year run at being a Cowboy fan, but also it's been a terrible 20-plus year run of being a Cowboy fan. I became a Cowboy fan in 1992. I saw them beat the Steelers in the Super Bowl, and at that moment as a child, I was going through things in my life. I was trying to make a decision as to what football team I would pick, and I had Redskins fans in my ears telling me, oh, you want to be down with the Skins, and somehow I dodged that bullet. I was wise, because something told me you could never follow a team that wouldn't respect the man for the color of his skin. And I said, no, I'm going to be a Cowboy fan because they fight against the evil of the Redskins. And I thought to myself, I saw Michael Irvin make one of the greatest plays I ever seen in my life. I talked about he caught the ball, took a hit that I thought he was going to die from, and he got up and slammed it on him. I was like, damn, that's the type of play that I like to see from my team. And now, all these years later, I've just slowly watched the deterioration. I remember we used to argue with my band, bro, about how Testaverde is actually a good quarterback, and he's going to bring us out of the nonsense. Because you know why? Because before that, we had Quincy Carter, and we had motherfucking Drew Henson and Hutchinson, and name after name of people that couldn't even snap the ball and hand it to a running back. So I was like, oh, Testaverde looked nice. He out there doing it at 40-something years old. We hype. We thinking, oh, we about to do something. No. Then came along Mr. Bledsoe, and I said, oh, maybe we could change some things. Maybe this is the dawn of a new age. You're crazy.
You had Bledsoe, dude. I forgot.
Matt, do you hear the turmoil, God. Matt? Do you hear now what I'm saying? That this is why I'm bringing all this up, because it ain't just one decision. This is just the epitome of it all. Because when you can't let when the Browns score 50-some points on you, man, it's over, bro.
So we're going to cut that sad music, but just to add to that, like, if you just told the offensive coordinator, hey, next week, you guys are going to score 38 points, that guy would
be awesome.
That guy would be like, hell yeah, we got this, guys. And then
you
go to the defense and be like, hey, guys, you're going to give up 49 points to the Browns. That's
no way in hell that's going to happen. That's what they would tell you. They'd be like, oh, that's impossible, man. We got this. No, you don't. They can't stop nobody.
In the middle of an apocalypse, something's happening, because 49 by the Browns, like, I don't give a fuck who's on the team. Like, the world shouldn't allow that to happen, because that's not real. That's not real.
Crazy, bro.
Human sacrifice, dogs and cats living together, mass hysteria.
And what's crazy is that the score is even badder than it looks, because, like, they scored points and made it get close to kind of be like, oh, you know, they put up 38. No, it was never close. At one point, it was like 35-14. Like, that's not a close football game, bro. That's an over and done game. That's why I turned that shit off. I was like, I can't do this anymore. I'm broken.
I would have turned it off, too, if I was
fucked. Like, this day has come. It's been brewing in me for a while, because I said to myself, I can't let one man just have so much control over how I feel about the day and the sun and the rain and all the happy things that I enjoy. Jerry Jones has destroyed me, man. I could have been great, God. Man.
You hear this, Jerry?
I could have been somebody, man. But I said, nah, I'm going to ride with the Cowboys, man. I could have been a Ravens fan. Look how I would have been living right now,
dude. Your friend, dude.
Listen to this, but man, I could have got out the NFC East at least, man. I could have, you know. Maybe had a dream to someday even see a playoff game that we might stand a chance at winning. They've never even had a chance, bro. The one year that they was really, really good, they were 13-3, and they lost to the Giants, and the Giants won the Super Bowl that year, bro. So, like, to me, like, that's what I'm saying. I'm done, bro. Like, there's not a single season I can look back and say, damn, they almost pulled that off. Like, no. Anytime they even got it close, they weren't really close. Like, I remember they went to the Vikings one year in the playoffs and went up there, and all of a sudden, Flo Adams hurt. And the guy that's behind him can't block. It's like, why are you on the team then? Jared Allen goes up there and gets like 5 sacks on Tony Romo, and everybody in Minnesota is just smiling from ear to ear. And I'm just like, okay, man. So apparently this all is a facade. Like, this is what I realized about them then and there. They only got one brick to their wall. There ain't no reinforcement behind it. So, like, if the starters are hurt, the backups are trash. I don't know why this is, but that's just the way the Cowboys run, bro. Like, I've seen the team's backups not be that bad. You know what I'm saying? So, I guess they can evaluate first-level talent, but second-level talent, nah. And that's why we're trash, bro. Like, it'll never – I'm just done, bro.
So, when maybe, is the funeral for your fandom of the Cowboys? Can we have, like, a funeral?
It was yesterday.
Week? Oh,
it
was yesterday. You already held it.
I buried it. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Oh, wow. I buried it in the coffin, bro. Like, yeah. I
you
saw,
just straight up killed it like a rabid dog and just threw it out in the backyard.
I'm done, bro. Like, well, I just like the NFL now. I just watch professional football.
I hate to tell you, I'm not going to remove the Cowboys logo from your team because, to be honest with you, Aaron, I think what we're seeing right in this moment is just an overreaction. I think inside you're saying these things, but you really don't believe that.
Matt, the Cowboys.
I know somewhere deep down in my heart, I still love you.